All right, so we got some poplars. Sorry, I wasn't, there'll be a little bit of, you know, recorded saw time with this poplar, but pile keeps growing. 2x8s, 2x10s, 2x24s. Of course, they're live edged. That way, you know, they're able to hone it in as tight as they want it. If they want to leave a little bark on one side, that's fine. They requested it square, I would definitely do that, but I pulled off good, wide, live-edged slabs that I could. Once I got it squared, I went ahead and, you know, obviously, 2x6, 2x8, 2x10, 12, and so on. See about getting a little saw time, though, with the poplar here. See if I can get a good setup anywhere. Got her tipping. Put you on the scrap pile here. Well, maybe. Afraid if that breeze goes too a little too much, it's going to tip her. But this piece has got to stabilize. There we go. All right. A little bit colder today. So I took a 2, left a 3-inch. Guy makes tables and stuff also, so said 3-inch stuff for some legs out of the poplar. Hopefully this 3x8 will work. Tractor's still broken. Got the Lambrafidis. So here's actually a very good representation of a certain defect. You know, I hear people mention this a lot, but no one, you know, all these other people I've watched, nothing against them. They're wonderful at what they do. You know, this is a difficult thing running a sawmill, whether it's hydraulic or not. So anyone who does that, props to you. A lot of work goes into it. But as I was saying, I hear the word pith thrown around a lot. The definition of pith is the small, soft structural core of the log. That's what we're looking at. It's not as exposed as I'd like to see it, because I tried to keep the pith centered in there. So maybe one more cut and I would have exposed it fully. If I took another inch off, you can see it right there. As I said, the small soft core occurring at the structural center of the log. Basically worthless, but as you can see, you know, on either side of the pith, if left wide enough, you can obtain rift or quartered sawn lumber, depending. It all kind of depends how the grain is facing, 45 or 90 to expose the medullary rays. But you know, as far as table legs go, I would split this, you know, pull the straight grain stuff off the side. That's what you want. The mineral, you know, in the grading world, mineral is a flag. That means I have to downgrade one grade. In oak it does. In poplar, there's no limit in the common grades to how much mineral is allowed. Just so everyone can see, you know, not every poplar log contains mineral. Sometimes lots of them do. And it's usually a sign of decay in the log. I'll see a lot of this rotten out, you know. People end up, you know, caring about this and watching it. I will, you know, take you to the big mill on occasion, and we will run through things there so you can kind of get a better idea, and not just me rambling at my house. I'm actually in the process of cooking dinner. Got ribs tonight. Might take you and show you those, but we'll get this loaded. Get my last poplar log out there loaded up. Then I have a catalpa log, and that'll do it for this load. And again, you know, you guys enjoy this, like and subscribe, and I will, you know, do better with the camera, obviously, figure stuff out a little more, but, you know, only if people are like, oh, I can, you know, watch this for a little bit. This guy's not that big of a douche. So thank you, like and subscribe.